Hello everyone, this is Sam Spade. Welcome to another Coding Fundamentals in Gmail tutorial. This tutorial is going to be a short philosophical talk on an idea that I think is important to programming, but may or may not apply to you. It's going to be a little bit different than normal. We're not going to have any code. I'm just going to talk through, again, a thing that I think is important to think about when you're learning to program, especially if you are a hobby programmer or someone who is learning on their own and not in a classroom. I want to start with saying that programming is, among many other things, problem solving. And especially if you're making a game, you're going to be solving thousands, if not hundreds of thousands, of small to large problems. Many of these problems will be very basic problems, problems that you may have solved before in other projects or that other people have solved before in other projects. And some of these problems are going to be unique to your specific game. And in general, you can sort of conceptualize this as getting from point A to point B, where point A is a problem where you have something and you don't know how to do it. And point B is you knowing how to do it. And there are basically, if I'm going to oversimplify it, two ways to get there. You can be told how to get from point A to point B, or you can find your own way from point A to point B. And one thing I want to stress is that there isn't a right answer to this. A lot of people will tell you that finding the way yourself is the way to go. And there's some truth to this, but if you wanted to go to your friend's house, and you said, hey, what's your address? And they said, no, I'm not going to tell you my address. Figure it out yourself. You'll learn so much more that way. That would be ridiculous. That's not how you want to learn where your friends live. You want them to give you the address, and then you want to plug that into Google and just be told how to get there. And that's the appropriate solution for that problem. And to use a more practical example, if you think about programming itself, if when you wanted to learn how to program, you couldn't take a class, no one could teach you even the basics of programming, that would be insane. You would never get anywhere. For most of us, all or most of our programming skill will come from building upon the knowledge that other people have. And you get that knowledge by being told it. So again, I want to stress that there is not a right way here. No way is inherently better. And in fact, most of the time when you're going from point A to point B, I think your path looks a little bit more like this. You veer from one side to the other and back and forth, and sometimes you backtrack and eventually you get there. So as I said, there are a lot of things that can be taught, such as the basics of programming or how a language works. Those are two of the things that I'm trying to get across in this tutorial series. There are also many other things that you can learn about programming. You can learn about algorithms, which I want to do a tutorial series on at some point, programming patterns, and really so much more. But there is sort of a category of things that you cannot be taught, or you cannot be told how to solve, is maybe a better way to put it. And that is new problems. If you encounter a problem that no one has ever seen before, then the only way to get the answer to that problem is to find it yourself, because no one can tell you how to do it because no one has seen it. And this may sound ridiculous, and I guess in some ways it is, but the truth is, if you're making a game, the problems you encounter in that game are going to be in some way unique. This can be for trivial things, such as the variable names that you've chosen, or less trivial things, such as the structure of your program as a whole. And you also have to consider that there are multiple ways to answer certain problems, and some of those answers will work better than others for what you're doing. That might just raise a new problem, which is, which of those answers do you go with? Which of those answers do you use? And this is a familiar story that I see played out all the time, and really not just with programming, but programming is our topic here. Someone has a problem, and we'll just say that this problem is illustrated by this trapezoid. They want the answer to this problem. So they go and they look for other people's answers. They go to the manual, and the manual gives them an answer that looks a little bit like this. Doesn't quite fit. They go to YouTube. They watch a tutorial. The tutorial gives them an answer that looks a little bit like this. Again, close but doesn't quite fit. They go to the marketplace and they get an asset. That asset gives them an answer that is pretty close but still not quite the right shape. They go to the forum and they ask a question. They get an answer, and that answer is very, very close, but just a little bit wrong. Here, in fact, all I've done is rotate it 90 degrees. And conceptually, these, you know, mismatches can be for any number of reasons. They can be people using different variable names or different program structures or making slightly different assumptions about how things are supposed to work as a whole, or covering a topic that is a little bit similar but not exactly what you want. But again, the point is that often when you have a problem and you go looking for an answer, all you'll really find is answers to problems that are similar to yours. Hopefully very similar, but probably not 100%. And I think that's the basic idea. Unless your problem is very simple, you are probably not going to get an answer from anyone that is 100% perfect. Some translation is going to be required between the answer that you get and the answer that you need. And especially if you're working on your own, you will have to do the translating yourself because you are the programmer. Again, just a simple illustration. You have a never-before-seen problem that is unique to your program, your game. You want an answer, so you go ask or you go look for answers, and what you're going to find are different but similar problems, and there's going to be an answer to those problems. But this answer right here is not quite going to be the answer that you need, and so you'll have to do some translating to get from here to here. And this is the key idea behind what I mean when I say that you are the programmer. It's simply a reminder that at the end of everything, you're the one responsible, or since I say it to myself, I'm the one responsible for coming up with the answers to my own questions when I'm coding. And I can certainly go ask for help. And in fact, I want to be very clear that nothing in this is meant to discourage people from asking for help. In fact, I think that's often, like I started with, that's sort of where you've got to start. You've got to go looking for help. You've got to go looking to the manual, to the tutorial, to the forums, etc. You've got to look for those answers somewhere. It's just pointing out that the answers you find will seldom be 100% what you need. And so it's important to put that little bit of extra effort in, and to remind yourself that you need to put that little bit of extra effort in to translate those answers to what is actually useful for you. So in summary, programming is, among many other things, about problem solving, and looking and asking for help is encouraged, and learning is very important, but ultimately you have to apply the answers. And that means that you have to solve those problems and do that work yourself because you are the program. And that's actually it for this tutorial. I don't have an additional resources slide, but you can find the links to this slide below, as always, and thanks for watching.